So we are back again for the very best Bleach episodes countdown all the way to October/December, whenever it's going to end, I'm not quite sure. And we are doing these just to have a bit of a nostalgia trip, to break down these scenes and see what we like the most and see if we can pick up on little details that the anime gave us back in the day. It may be correlation to the final chapter, who knows, but I thought it's a fun little thing prepping us for October's release of the Thousand Year Blood War arc, and also to help with videos and consistency for you guys as well. The last video didn't do well, so please make this video do a little bit better to, you know, to kind of incentivize, you know, a bit of a community here. So, comment down below if you like these videos, drop a like as it always helps. And let's get on today's reaction video. And we're here for the Soul Society of Bleach this week with, I believe, Byakuya versus Ichigo, but not because it's the saving of Rukia. So, yeah. Nostalgia. I love the drums in this. The drums go too hard, and especially the ending. If you know the ending, that screamo just hits because it's just so unexpected. And then, of course, I have a guilty pleasure for the transition into White Ichigo there. Mwah. French kiss. Beautiful. There it is. The screamo. Yeah. And then the Menos Grande coming out. The Hell Butterfly. If you know, you know. Grande sponsor! Yeah, there you go. Love that. Love that. Don't know why, it just rolls off the tongue. And here we are. Many people were kind of telling me to watch the Ichigo versus Okiura fight, and this isn't on me at all. This is the top 13, even though this is like the 10th episode, top 13 most voted episodes by the Japanese and Club Kubo, or worldwide. I can't remember who voted for it. But yeah, this is in order from least to most voted episodes. So I don't get a choice in what's playing on TV. This is a TV broadcast at the moment. So, yeah. I don't know what's going to happen next week. We'll find out on the Twitter account on Bleach Animation later today. So we'll see what we get next week. But again, banger episode. I can see why this was chosen. I believe this is the one of Ichigo saving Rukia. I think that's more towards the end, though. Yeah, this is where all the captains gather up, isn't it? Oh no, this might be where Ichigo absolutely blitzes Isane, as she should, because she's useless, and I don't know why you guys like her. Oh, I like myself a tall dummy mommy. She ain't even a dummy mommy, she's just tall. I have to spit facts. If you are comparing her to any Bleach female, she is literally bottom barrel. She just is. Oh, but she's tall. I haven't heard like this OST in like such a long time. And we probably won't like hear it in the new anime, but there's something nostalgic about this OST. Yeah, there's just, love it. What are you guys' thoughts on Kyone and Satoru? I almost forgot his name then. They're funny characters, but does Kyone deserve to be lieutenant? This is Ukitake and Kyoraku coming out. No, it's just Ukitake coming out, isn't it? With the shield? Yeah, there it is, yeah. And I must say, Orihime in a Shinigami robe was peak outfit Orihime. Do not care. I have spoken. It's so funny hearing Yachiru speak, considering what we know about her, about why she was so obsessed with Kenny and why she enjoyed the fact that Ichigo gave Kenpachi a good fight, because she knew that that was kind of on Kenpachi's road to development in certain aspects, so kind of like that. And Yamamoto, you really thought Rukia deserved this type of execution? Like, all your years as a head captain, you didn't think something might be off just slightly? In hindsight, you know? I mean, for the story purposes, sure, it works, but in hindsight, you just kind of like, maybe not. I did always find that funny as well, like the Kido corpse when they were doing that with this Sokyoku right there. They were doing like the ninja hand signs and whatnot. And I just thought how annoying it would be for Periot members or Puro animators to consistently do hand signs in Naruto like that. Like how much like animation and frames they would waste on that. And the fact that they did that all the time in like old Naruto in comparison to now just goes to show like how much, you know, dedication they had to their craft, or talent they had to their craft back then. Or maybe it didn't at all, who knows? There's the Sokyoku. See, my thoughts on it are a bit weird because it's like, what is it, the power of a million Zanpakutos? And you're like, well, what's what's that scale to? Like, what is a Zanpakuto on its own? Like, is it a third class, a fifth class Zanpakuto? Like, what? How do you quantify a million Zanpakuto? It means nothing, I felt. And really, all the captains there for an execution of, like, a zero-seated officer? Just a seated officer, like, no rank. Seems a bit sus. Like, when you think about it, like, in hindsight, it's sus. Which is funny. I did love the fire effects in old Bleach. And there's something about analog animation that really had a beautiful flair to it, you know? Notice, there's the Phoenix. I guess the Sokoku spear doesn't really exist anymore, but again, it was a cool concept that I think maybe should have stuck around. Maybe it would have been like a cool little flashback if Yamamoto would single-handedly use it or something, you know, since it is like a Phoenix fire type. But these shots are just amazing, to be honest. The lighting, the effects of the faces of the expressions on the captains, like they're seeing it for the first time. I did like this scene, like her accepting death at this moment. You can tell she's shook though. Yeah, you can tell she's scared, but like she's accepted it. A very powerful moment there that I like. Where's the infamous yo? Oh, great OST as well. There he is. He's in the Shihoin Crest cape thing that allows him to fly. Or levitate? I can't remember. There was two that could allow him to fly. Which was that, like, dragon claw thing. Yes, because that's what happens when you save someone's life. You just yell at them. But I understand it, because Rukia had just accepted everything. And then for her to have that change in such a drastic shift is probably infuriating. His Zanpakuto is stopping the spear, which is the power of a million Zanpakuto. Whoa! He's going in for a second shot. And this is where Ukitake and Kyoraku come and do the business. Which is weird that the Shihoins also have a thing to stop this specific sphere. Like, what was they cooking? What type of equipment were they cooking? That would have been a cool clash, I'm not gonna lie. It would have been sick. This was a badass moment. I do like this. Two of the oldest captains doing the business. Actually, I want to see Unohana's reaction to this. Old man Yama's like... And the thing is, you know Yamamoto low-key kind of let him because he was interested in what they were doing? Like, he was taken aback by it. Where's Unohana's reaction? Probably deadpanned, granted, is what I would imagine her facial feature is like. I wouldn't imagine she'd be shocked by it. Oh, the blue eyes too. I do miss the blue eyes. And again, even though it's like been stretched out widescreened, it doesn't look bad at all. And this isn't even Tokyo MX HD. This is Tokyo MX Standard Edition, so... King. That's my fucking main character. What a goat. He about to put in the work. Now, can Asano get slapped, please? I don't hate Asano at all. I just... After the amount of abuse that I got on Twitter, after saying she's kind of mid, nah, you guys getting the slander now. There she is. Mid. I think they're talking about how Ichigo's going to get her out of here. And he said, like, oh, you know, I'll just beat Byakuya too. And she's like, well, what about this? He's like, I'll just beat them as well. But I just like, I do like that nonchalant confidence of Ichigo. And here's Renju, the goat, the king. There he is. Look how happy she is in comparison to being held by Ichigo. Look at that sigh of relief that he is happy and healthy. See that banter between her and Ichigo when he saved her? And look at that genuine happiness when she sees Renji. Really makes you think. Good memes, good memes. Oh yeah, run as fast as you can, get out of here. Yep. And here it is, it's about to kick off. Yeah! When the music riff kicks in, it's over. Oh, I can't. How could I even skip any of this, man? Live, the copyright's gonna go mad. She set up Isane. She set up Isane for L's. That's crazy. Amida about to get clapped as well. Here it is. It's about to look beautiful. Let's go! What is that, mate? At least Omida's looks cool. Did look cool. Yeah, get upper-handed. And you are about to get flat-chested. Boom. And then Byakuya gets salty. Let's go. And it's going to end there, isn't it? Took you long enough, Byakuya? Yep. Da-na. Beautiful. Love that. Now, everything about this episode is just suspenseful, emotional, and then at the end, just makes you want to watch the next episodes. Oh, this is an amazing ending, too. Oh, man. When she says, I want to change my life, that hits so bad. Yeah, it is Yui. It's Yui! Oh, I was gassing up Yui not long ago on Twitter, bro. She's an amazing singer because she can do acoustic guitar so well. The drum beat is amazing on this song especially. And her voice is like liquid gold. And the direction too, like the everything. Love this song. One of my top endings. One of them. Yes. Yes. Acoustic guitars. Go away, Kimetsu no Midya. Anyone still playing this game? I wonder if we'll get anything for the Aniplex online festa. Might do. When is it? September? Oh, here we go. The ending. Cons thing, whatever it's called. I forgot. Let's see what the joke is in this one. Oh, bro, this guy, man. What is his name, man? Kurumadani? Something like that? Like, nobody remembers this man. There you go. Yeah, right, bro, you're a soul reaper, and you get embodied by random humans. Like, you're a joke, bro. I'm glad you got replaced in the Blood War. Right, it seems like that is the end of the Bleach live reaction. So, let's swish over to the main screen. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed today's reaction, fellas. Of course, if you did in fact like it, of course, there's a like button at the bottom, a subscribe, and a comment section in the comment section down below of what you liked the most as well. I did enjoy the Blu-ray version of this as well. Watching it in standard definition, there's not that much of a difference, and I was still very much impressed by today's episode. And again, going back to Soul Society towards the end is always a treat to see Rukia, see Renji, see Byakuya, see their clashes, see Isane get absolutely obliterated. You did this to me. I wouldn't have done this if you guys hadn't come at my neck when the BBS swimsuits came out. So you have no one to blame but yourselves, right? So, and you want to slander Momo, so I'm going to slander Isane. It just is what it is, right? So anyway, if you like these videos, please let them do well, because I do enjoy doing these. It's a nice little consistent thing every Sunday about 2 o'clock if in the UK time, give or take. So, you know, I like them. So please show some support, show some love. And I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.